In 1972, Michael Brown and Joseph Goldstein discovered that the cholesterol level within the blood of patients with familial hypercholesterolemia, or FH for short, is many times that of their healthy counterparts. Through research, they investigated the molecular basis of the disease and realized that this is due to the inability of LDL to cross the cell membrane. Yet, how do macromolecules like LDL cross the plasma membrane? The plasma membrane is a mosaic of biomolecules such as cholesterol, proteins, and carbohydrates, etc., embedded in the phospholipid bilayers. When cholesterol is circulated in the bloodstream, its hydrophobicity causes it to deposit in the epithelium of blood vessels, resulting in atherosclerosis. Thus, the major form of cholesterol transport in the bloodstream is found to be cholesterol esters packaged in apoproteins, hence forming the low-density lipoproteins, or LDL. Nevertheless, LDLs are relatively polar and are hindered from direct diffusion across the plasma membrane. Researchers then hypothesized that there might be a specific protein molecule mediating this mechanism of endocytosis. The protein receptor responsible for the process of LDL uptake is now known to be LDLR. LDLR is a transmembrane glycoprotein divided into several domains, majorly including the ligand-binding domain, the transmembrane domain, and the cytoplasmic domain. The ligand-binding domain contains a 7-time disulfide bonded cysteine-rich repeat, which is a cluster of negatively charged amino acids binding its ligand, ApoE, by attaching to its positively charged alpha helix. The cytoplasmic domain of the LDLR plays a pivotal role in clustering receptors in coated pits, either through interaction with clathrin itself or with some proteins associated with clathrin on the cytoplasmic side of the membrane. A conserved hexapeptide sequence, FX and PXY, where X is random, in the cytoplasmic tail of LDLR is considered essential for coated pit clustering. In vitro test results indicated that this sequence adopts a reverse turn conformation, the presence of which in the cytoplasmic portion of a receptor strongly correlates with internalization efficiency. The signal for targeting a membrane protein to coated pits hence depends upon the secondary structure of the FX and PXY motif, and plays a critical conformational role by enabling binding to adapter molecules. It is a mutation in a 6-amino acid internalization signal, the mutation of tyrosine to cysteine, to be exact, that leads to a certain type of familial hypercholesterolemia, which sees those afflicted unable to achieve a concentrated LDL receptors in coated pits. To briefly summarize what have been introduced so far, recognition of LDL is not the sole function of the receptor. The LDL receptors are localized in regions of the plasma membrane where the protein clathrin is heavily concentrated, called clathrin-coated pits. The LDL receptor is bound to clathrin at its internalization signal, which is within the cytoplasmic region of the LDL receptor via an adapter protein. Clathrin plays an active role in the formation of the intracellular transport vesicle formed by the process of endocytosis. It forms a triskelion shape consisting of three heavy chains and three light chains, which associate with one another to form a basket-like lattice structure. This structure distorts the membrane and initiates vesicle budding. These invaginated pits are then budded off from the plasma membrane with the aid of a GTP binding protein called dynamin. Dynamin functions by assembling as a ring around the rim of the invaginated pit and undergoing a conformational change that allows the invaginated pit to break away from the major plasma membrane to become an independent clathrin-coated vesicle. Receptor-mediated endocytosis via clathrin-coated pits is the major mechanism of how cells internalize extracellular ligands and regulate cell surface receptor traffic. Clustering of the LDL receptor may result from weak protein-protein interactions relying on the cooperative behavior of multiple proteins in the clathrin lattice, or may require a novel adapter molecule. The formation of coated vesicles is regulated by small GTP binding proteins mediating the assembly of vesicles by recruiting adapter proteins. Next, we take a closer look at the process of vesicle formation. For the formation of clathrin-coated vesicle, A small GTP binding protein, ARF1, is in the GDP form in the beginning. A guanine nucleotide exchange factor, ARFGEF, activates ARF1 GDP to ARF1 GTP, which recruits a GGA adapter protein. GGA binds to the cytosolic tail of a transmembrane receptor with its luminal cargo and also recruits a second adapter protein, AP1, serving as a binding site for assembly of a clathrin coat. During the transport of vesicles, the GTP bound to ARF1 is hydrolyzed to GDP, and the ARF1 GDP will release from the membrane through a cycle. Loss of ARF1 and the action of uncoating enzymes weaken the binding of the clathrin coat complex, allowing chaperone proteins in the cytoplasm to remove the coat on the vesicle membrane. This vesicle usually then moves on to the endosome for further sorting and distribution of its contents. Molecules taken up at the cell surface via endocytosis are processed and digested along the secretory pathway and the endocytic pathway. Early endosomes separate molecules targeted for recycling back to the plasma membrane from those destined for degradation in lysosomes. Some cargoes transported into early endosomes enter the recycle endosome, where cell membrane receptors are recycled and other unwanted substances were eliminated. The other early endosomes mature into late endosomes and eventually transition into lysosomes as the internal pH gradually lowers. The acidification provides double protection against uncontrolled digestion of the contents of the cytosol. Even if the lysosomal membrane were to break down, hydrolases synthesized in the Golgi are only active in acidic pH. Overall speaking, unraveling the mechanism of receptor-mediated endocytosis, as well as the intracellular protein trafficking pathway, allows us to understand the molecular basis of LDL uptake and its role in maintaining cholesterol homeostasis. Clustered in clathrin-coated pits on the plasma membrane, LDL receptors not only bind but also internalize the LDL macromolecules. The invaginated pits then dissociate from the plasma membrane and form coated vesicles, which are then removed of their surface coats and transported along the secretory pathway for further processing and degradation. Lysosomal hydrolysis in turn leads to regulatory actions and proves to be the key to cholesterol metabolism. The characteristics of the LDL receptor system may suggest models for receptor systems in general.